When I'm running navigation courses, I get asked quite often which is better for navigating, a compass with mils or a compass with degrees. So I thought it'd be interesting to make a short video just to look at the differences and to try to give an answer. The first thing to remember is that there are lots of different types of compasses, and regardless of the use that they're designed for, most of them have one thing in common, in that they'll give us a number which signifies a direction. If someone else understands the number, they'll also understand the direction without us having to point or explain or draw a line on a map. Obviously, there are some exceptions, like orienteering compasses tend not to have numbers because they're not needed. Plotting compasses also don't have numbers, but most types of compasses that you and I will use do have a numbering system. If you're using your compass to navigate while you're trekking or hill walking or mountaineering, within reason, it makes absolutely no difference which numbering system you use, as long as you and everybody else who needs to understands which direction the numbers signify. And obviously, most importantly, you can use your compass to navigate safely. If you really want to, you could even invent your own system, your own numbering system for a compass. Let's say you decide to divide a circle into 10 units, and to make it a little bit more accurate, you divide each unit into 5 segments. You could sell someone who was at point A on this map that if they wanted to get to point B, they needed to walk on a bearing of 17 segments. As you can see, that would work fine. So as long as everybody understands it, it doesn't really make much difference. But obviously, most people aren't going to invent their own compass numbering systems. They're just going to buy one from a shop or buy it online. And this is going to come in either grads, degrees, or mils. Just to get grads out the way first, grads, by the way, are an abbreviation of gradients. They're not much use for navigating over hills or mountains, and they tend to be used mainly by land surveyors. This is a Suunto KB400. Which has the circle divided into 400 gradients, and surveyors will use these as they tend to use geometric shapes as opposed to north, south, etc. So it makes using grads much simpler. So let's have a look at the main two numbering systems on compasses, which are mils and degrees, and let's discuss what they're useful for and also what they're not useful for. So firstly, degrees. With this numbering system, we divide a circle into 360 equal segments, or degrees, from the old French word degré, meaning a step. Each degree can also be divided again into 60 minutes, and each minute can be divided again into 60 seconds. But from a map reading and navigation viewpoint, we're only really interested in degrees, as anything smaller is probably not usable with a handheld compass. When you were at school, you were told, as a fact, that a circle had 360 degrees. You weren't told why 360 was a magic number. It could have been 456 degrees in a circle, or it could have been 789. Could have been anything. So even though 360 is just an arbitrary number, it doesn't really matter. As long as everybody uses the same system, 360 is as good a number as any. There's many theories as to why we divide a circle into 360. It could be down to the ancient Babylonians, who used a sexagesimal system, which is one that uses a base value of 60. It could be that ancient civilizations had 12 months a year with 30 days. And as certain constellations of stars appeared to go all the way around the sky each year and return to the same point, they basically returned approximately every 360 days. It could be that some ancient civilization realized that you could fit 6 equilateral triangles into a circle. There's lots of theories, and I honestly don't know which one's true. So it's best to say it is what it is, and there are 360 degrees in a circle. On a compass, north is shown as 0 degrees, east is 90, south is 180, and west is 270. In most cases, when you're navigating on land, but bear in mind it's different at sea, the direction is simply given as a number. For example, let's walk on a bearing of 130 degrees for 10 minutes. Or you could say, from the peak, the wall junction is 400 meters at 140 degrees. So that's degrees. And if degrees are a 360th of a circle, now we can have a look at mils. But before we can start looking at mills, we have to identify which specific type of mills we're talking about. A mill is short for the Latin word mille, meaning a thousandth. So a mill radian is a thousandth of a radian. And regardless of what the sales rep might have told you in the shop or what you may read on virtually every website, handheld navigation compasses don't use the mill radian system. So what is a mill radian and why aren't they used on compasses? To find this out, we need to go back to our school days and remember some basic trigonometry. Yay, what fun. So as you may know, this is a circle and the line around the circle is called the circumference. The distance from the center of the circle to the circumference is called the radius. Let's say this radius is 1, 2, 3. That could be inches, centimeters, miles, kilometers, any unit of measurement. If we take a line which is the same length as a radius and wrap it around the circumference and then extend lines from both ends of the arc back to the center of the circle, the angle between these two lines is a radian. Don't forget that mil means a thousandth, so a thousandth of this particular radian would be called a mil radian. Now there's 6,283 mil radians in a complete circle, and if you look at your compass, you'll see that it's divided into 6,400 units, not 6,283. So your compass isn't using mil radians, but rather it's a numbering system called NATO mils. There are other systems, as an example, the Russians and the Chinese both have a system where their circle is divided into 6,000 mils. Okay, there's not much difference between mil radians and NATO mils, but as NATO mils were originally devised by the military, this difference is really important, as unless it's accounted for, it would mean that artillery would miss the target. The reason militaries use the various mil system is that maths goes both ways. It does take some maths to do it, but don't forget that since at least the 12th century, the original word computer from the Latin computare, which means arithmetic, was used to describe people whose job it was to calculate the trajectory of artillery. So the military have a long history of using maths in warfare. In the modern world, it's simple to convert NATO mils to degrees or radians. And don't forget that the length of a radian arc is the same as a radius. I'm not going to go into it a lot, as there's loads of websites which give much greater detail about shooting targets accurately using mils. You can also get a phone app which will do it for you. But the basics are, if you know the distance from something, so you can think about that as the radius, then you can easily work out how big it is. Or if you know how big something is, that would be the size of the arc on the circumference, then you can easily work out its distance. But I'm only interested in civilian navigation with a handheld compass. As I said at the start of the video, I get asked by my course participants whether they should use mils or degrees. So let's just look at this from a hill walking and mountaineering viewpoint. An obvious benefit of degrees is that most non-military people use them. So if you've taken a bearing in mils and you want to pass it on to somebody else, you're going to need a calculator to convert it from one system to another. As I've said, the fundamental difference between degrees and NATO mils is that in degrees you have 360 units in a circle, and NATO mils you have 6,400. Now, using those two numbers, it could be argued that as each increment on the compass dial is smaller, it must be more accurate. But from our view, which is map reading and navigation, this makes no sense in the real world. It's simply not possible using a handheld compass to take a bearing with an accuracy of better than 1 or 2 degrees, which would be around, I don't know, 18 to 35 and a half NATO mils. Then if you add in calculation errors when adjusting for magnetic declination, plus the normal lack of walking accuracy when following a compass bearing, you can see why all competent navigators use a compass with degrees rather than mils. Mind you, if you do use mils, that's fine, keep on using them. Same goes for degrees. Whichever system you use, it's absolutely fine as long as you and everybody else who you're walking with understands which direction the numbers mean and that you can use your compass to navigate safely. But if I had to make a choice, and if you're new to navigation and wondering which type of compass to get, my advice would be to buy a compass with degrees.